Let us spend a few moments in silent prayer as we focus our hearts and minds listening to our gathering music. Welcome, everyone, to our service of worship on this, the fourth Sunday in the season of Advent, this season when we watch and wait and we prepare for the coming of Christ. Now, today in our reading, unlike the last two Sundays, when we heard in the gospel reading about the forerunner to Jesus, John the Baptist, today we hear about Mary. And we hear in our gospel reading Mary's song, the Magnificat. We will also hear it in our song, our hymn after the sermon, as well as in a special solo by Yvonne. So we focus on Mary today as we prepare for Christmas. Now our service today begins with confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who alone does wonders, who lifts up the lowly, who fills the hungry with good things. Amen. Let us confess our sin, trusting in the tender mercy of our God. God, for whom we wait, in the presence of one another, we confess our sin before you. When we fail in believing that your good news is for us, when we falter in our call to tend to your creation, when we find our sense of self in material wealth, when we fear those different from ourselves, when we forget that we are your children and turn away from your love, forgive us, Blessed One, and assure us again of your saving grace. Amen. God in Christ Jesus has looked upon us with favor. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, our sins are forgiven. We are children of the Most High, inheritors of the eternal promise, and recipients of divine mercy. God, strengthen us anew to follow the way of peace. Amen. Stand. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Stir up your power, Lord Jesus, Lord Christ, and come. With your abundant grace and might, free us from the sin that binds us, that we may receive you in joy and serve you always. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Thank you.
Advent is a time to praise. Advent is a time to remember God's faithfulness.
Praise the Lord and rejoice in Christ's goodness.
Advent is a time to remember God's blessings.
Praise the Lord and rejoice in Christ's goodness.
Advent is a time to remember God's promises. Advent is a time to celebrate the end of darkness.
Praise Jesus, the light of the world.
This morning, we will light 4 candles and are reminded that we wait, watch, and prepare for Jesus. This candle reminds us that Advent is a time to give praise for what God has done, for what God is doing, and for what God will bring to completion. As the light of Advent grows brighter, it reminds us that we move closer to receiving the gift of the Savior, Jesus, the light of the world. Let us pray. God in heaven, we look to you from a distance, from a world filled with darkness. Help us to seek the light of your truth as we remember your promises and offer our praise for your amazing gift to us. Amen.
Have a seat on this step there, Max and Charlie. Sit over here. And we also have Sadie. Do you know Sadie? Maybe you don't know. Sadie, this is Max and Charlie. I don't know if you can see them there. You do?
Yeah.
Great. Well, how's everyone doing? Good. How's the preparations for Christmas? Good. What's changed in your house in the last few weeks? There's a Christmas tree. Do you have a Christmas tree, Sadie? You do, right?
Yes.
We heard about that last week. What else? Anything? Any other decorations? Oh, Christmas lights. In the house? Outside of the house?
Outside.
Wow, that sounds awesome. I don't know. Do you have any lights up, Sadie?
On a tree we do, but not outside.
Oh, okay. Well, I wanted to ask you guys, well, first of all, I should say, it sounds like your preparations are coming along well. I wanted to ask you, as we prepare for Christmas, we're getting awfully close, aren't we?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Are lit on the Advent wreath. 4. That means the next time we light a candle on that wreath, it will be Christmas Eve.
Mm.
So we're awfully close.
Mm.
Now, Let me ask you, do you have any favorite Christmas songs? Any? Do you have any favorite Christmas songs? Do you know any Christmas songs?
Yes.
So what might your favorite Christmas songs be, Sadie?
Probably like Jingle Bells.
Jingle Bells? Yeah. How about that one? Do you guys know that one? Yeah. How about Away in a Manger? Do you know that one?
Yeah, I love that one.
Yeah, great. How about, let's see, Oh, Little Town of Bethlehem? Do you know that one? Oh, Little Town of Bethlehem.
No, I don't know that one.
So, any other ones you might know? How about Joy to the World? Do you guys know that one? Joy
oh, yeah.
To the world, the Lord has come. You know what my favorite is?
What?
Go Tell It on the Mountain. Do you know that one? Do either of you guys know that one? Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Right? That's how that one goes. Well, let me tell you that we are going to be singing those songs on Christmas Eve. We have our regular family service at 4 o'clock here on Christmas. We'll also be on Zoom, and then we have the 6 o'clock service here, and then the 10:30 service here. And the 6 will also be on Zoom, so you can join us from wherever you're at. Now, the reason I bring up songs is because in our gospel reading, we hear a song from Mary. It's called Mary's Song. You see, we hear about when Mary went to visit her cousin, and she heard about the birth of John the Baptist, and Mary's cousin was so excited that she blessed Mary. She said, "Blessed are you, Mary." And then Mary started singing. Well, we don't know if she started singing, but she did say these words that we call Mary's song, also known as the Magnificat. So she created her favorite song for the birth of her son, Jesus, that we celebrate at Christmas, the birth of Jesus. Okay, can you fold your hands and bow your head and let us pray? Dear God, we give you thanks for this day. We thank you that we are oh so close to the celebration of the birth of Jesus at Christmas. Be with us today and in the coming days, especially on Christmas, as we celebrate your birth. In your name we pray. Amen. Well, it's so great to see you too, and it's so great to see you, Sadie. And I hope you all have a Merry Christmas, especially if I don't see you. Merry Christmas.
A reading from the prophet Micah. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore, he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Let us stand.
Nothing in all creation can separate us from the love of God. Nothing in all creation can separate us from the love of God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the first chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his descendants forever." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts and minds be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer. Amen. As I said, today is the fourth and final Sunday in this season of Advent. And the season of Advent can be as complicated, contradictory, and crazy as our lives outside these walls. Just look at where we have been in these last few weeks. On the first Sunday in Advent, we heard stories of distress among the nations, of how people will faint from fear, and how heaven and earth will pass away. And then over the last couple of weeks, we've encountered the fire and brimstone ministry of John the Baptist, how he called the crowds that came out to be baptized him, "You brood of vipers," how he exhorted his followers to bear fruit worthy of repentance. Well, in our reading today from Luke, it's not as immediately jolting as the previous three, but on other levels, it's still complicated, and even, I think, somewhat astounding. We begin with some pre-birth stories of John and Jesus. In fact, what we have is the meeting of the mothers of these two boys. And it's really a touching scene. The young and pregnant Mary hurries to the home of her older relative, who is herself in the middle of a joy-filled but somewhat perplexing pregnancy. According to Luke, Elizabeth's body teaches her theological truths. At Mary's greeting, Elizabeth feels a stirring in her womb that evokes her recognition of who it is to whom Mary will give birth. Elizabeth gives voice to the first confession of faith in Jesus. Blessings pour from her mouth, blessing the child who is to come and blessing Mary. And Mary's response is to sing the song known as the Magnificat. Now, in the first part of this song, Mary praises and rejoices God, who has looked with favor upon her. And in the second half, the focus shifts to a more general celebration of God's deeds and ways. And that is in three parts. The first and the last celebrate God's mercy. And the center elaborates on what happens when God's strength is displayed. The proud and powerful are scattered and brought down, and the lowly are lifted up. The hungry are filled with good things. The rich are sent away empty. It's important to recognize how the celebration of God's mercy at the beginning and the end, and the center describing a reversal of fortunes, how the two of these interact with each other. Within the frame of God's mercy, I think the center loses any tone of vengeance. Instead, an economy marked by scarcity and competition is replaced by one characterized by generosity. The powerful no longer get to exercise power over others. This beautiful scene of Mary and Elizabeth meeting and Mary's subsequent response are most familiar and comforting. But if you think about it, there are some questions that arise. Where are the fathers or husbands in this scene? What's the meaning of the interplay between these generations, between the religiously traditional and the new? Elizabeth was the wife of a priest in the temple, Mary lowly and unmarried. Mary's song sounds like something a prophet would proclaim. And for us who live in the most powerful and rich nation in the world, maybe it's a bit uncomfortable. On the face of it, this passage is a wonderful and soothing scene. Yet just below the surface, there are complexities and seemingly disturbing contradictions. And maybe it's just a bit like this season in our lives, with its complexities of thought and feelings, its contradictions of consumerism in the service of love and generosity. The seeming complexities and contradictions from this season of Advent and our gospel reading are all about one thing: the fulfillment of God's promise to us, the salvation of all humanity. It's a story and promise that goes way back to the beginning and to Abraham. It's a salvation that has been proclaimed from generation to generation, but that now, in the life and death of the one that is to be born, will be given its most complete and final demonstration. It is about mercy, not sacrifice. It is about love and forgiveness. To be sure, this can be a complex and confusing time of the year, both inside the church and outside our walls. One moment we hear about fear and dismay among nations. The next we hear of peace and joy. We miss those who won't be with us this Christmas. Yet we're so glad for the new ones. And we wonder who might not be with us next Christmas. To be sure, this is a multifaceted and perplexing time of year. Yet it's all about love and salvation through the one who is coming. Amen. May the peace of God, which passes all human understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Let us pray. In this season of watching and waiting, let us pray for all people and places that yearn for God's presence. Nurturing God, you give us life and care for our every need. Use the church's gifts and ministries for your service, bringing your word to all who seek your transforming grace. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Creator God, you proclaim your boundless love for all that you have made. Renew barren lands, polluted waters, and melting ice caps. Make us servants of your creation that brings forth abundant life. We pray to the Lord. righteous God. You bring down the mighty and lift up the lowly. Strengthen those who seek justice. Bless the work of community organizers, activists, journalists, and all who call our attention to imbalances of power. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Compassionate God, you proclaim your love and mercy. Show your loving kindness to teen parents and those who are pregnant. Comfort any struggling with infertility and those who await test results, are in treatment and hospice care, and all others in need, especially the Aney family, Florinda Madole, Faith Mooney, Gail Grissom, Siggy Urich, Dorothy Griffith, Neva Conrad, Christy McCormick, Judy Hansen, the Reed family, Bob and LaVon Baylor, Carol and Hal Shirley, Vern and Laura, Mary and Jeff, Jane, Annegret, Rose, Marie, and all those we name out loud or hold in the quiet of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Gracious God, you fill the hungry with good things. Bless the feeding ministries of this congregation and community. Guide us to share your bounty with those who hunger or live in poverty. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Draw near to us, O God, and receive our prayers. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us stand. Lord Jesus, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Would you share that peace with one another? Peace be with you. May be seated. Just a few announcements. First of all, take note of the announcements that will be up on the screen at the end of the service during our sending music. Also, please know our adult education class continues today at 10:45 in the parish hall and on Zoom. We are looking at a series called Oh God, Now What? That sounds interesting, doesn't it? The subtitle is 20 Years After 9/11 and What Has Happened in Our Faith, in the Christian Religion, in the last 20 years. And if you think about it, a lot has happened in our world and in our religion in the last 20 years. So if you're interested at all, please come. And like I said, it'll continue for a number of weeks in the new year, but it happens today. Also, please know our Christmas Eve services. 4 is our family service. We'll be here in person as well as on Zoom. And then 6 o'clock is our lessons and carols, also in person and on Zoom. And then the 10:30 service will only be here in the sanctuary. Let us then prepare for Holy Communion. ¶¶ Stand. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God thanks and praise. Holy God, you alone are holy, you alone are God. The universe declares your praise beyond the stars, beneath the seas, within each cell, with every breath. Generations bless your faithfulness through the water, by night and day, across the wilderness, out of exile, into the future. We give you thanks for your dear Son at the heart of human life, near to those who suffer, beside the sinner, among the poor, with us now. I invite those at home to raise your piece of bread. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." For those at home, let us eat of the bread of life. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." You may be seated. Let us stand. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen.
Let us pray. Most High God, you have come among us at this table. By the Spirit's power, form us to be bearers of your word, sharing gifts of mercy and grace with all. Through Christ Jesus, our host and our guest.
The God of hope, fill us with all joy and peace in believing, so that we may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit, through Christ Jesus, for whom we wait. Amen.
Go in peace. Christ is near. Thank you.
Before we are excused, I would like to say a special thanks to Dayan Lim, who did play that beautiful piece. Thank you very much, as well as to Yvonne for that beautiful piece about Mary. And Dawn, thank you very much as well. And of course, thank you to the choir, Andre and Laura as well, for the beautiful music today. Thank you.